Welcome to Arch Creek Park. My name is Amy and I'm one of the naturalists here at the park.
What is Arch Creek Park?
Arch Creek Park is a site of a natural bridge. We had an archway that was made by nature and it went over the creek that's out there and it attracted people for thousands of years. 2,000 years is as far as back as we know. The Tequesta Indians lived here 2,000 years ago amongst the natural bridge.
Tequesta Indians were a Native American tribe that lived in South Florida.
How do you know they lived here so long ago?
By all the artifacts we found in our Tequesta Midden. So we have shell fragments or shell tools and shell fragments, pottery, and different animal bones that we find in our Midden site. And I have a few artifacts that you guys can touch and feel. And these are actual artifacts. These are things that the Tequestas actually used and made. So you guys are holding things that are 2,000 years old. Isn't that awesome? That's very cool. I think this is a very cool way to touch and feel history. So this is a conch shell, and that actually was made into a hammer at one point.
What is an artifact?
An artifact is something that's been changed by people. So we know that people change them because they all have those holes in them, and that's how we know that it's an artifact and not just a shell that's lying on the ground. Because they couldn't get things from Home Depot, right?
No.
No, they had to actually make things. And then we also find other parts of animals. So we find shark vertebrae. These were actually used as weights at one point for fishing lines. And you can see one of them actually has a little hole in it. We also find pottery in our Midden site. And pottery is really cool because they actually had to make this. So they would find clay and then they would mold it. Not only did the Tequestas live along the natural bridge, but pioneers and early settlers started to come and move here after the Tequestas were gone because of the bridge. The bridge was a connecting point from one side of the creek to the other.
Can we see the bridge?
Of course we can. Let's go check it out.
Yes.
The natural limestone bridge has an arch shape and goes over a natural freshwater creek, thus the name Arch Creek. The Tequesta Indians settled here because they could use the water for drinking, fishing, and transportation. And the bridge made it easy to travel back and forth from one side to the other.
Hi everyone, I'm Miss Sarah and I'm an archaeologist with the Florida Public Archaeology Network. An archaeologist is someone who looks for clues to the people that lived here in the past. And they look at this by studying a lot of the things they left behind, like their trash. So what we're standing on is called a midden, and it's the trash that people left behind a long time ago, because back then there was no garbage truck, right? So instead, people made a pile of trash, but we're standing on it right now. And you can see over here, there's some shell and everything that people would have been eating. The things people would eat the animal and then throw the bones and the shell away. Would you guys like to see some of the shell we find in archaeological sites?
Yes.
So this is a strombus shell. So that was a very tasty animal people liked to eat in the past. And then they would throw out the shell, so you can actually see strombus all over in this area. And another thing people used as tools were these big crown conch shells. So here we have a hole in the shell, and then we think what people did was they would take a stick like this and put it in like that. And then you could use this as a hammer.
The conch hammer is like a modern hammer.
Can you guys imagine having to build your house and chop down trees with a tool like that?
It would take a long time.
It would take a long time. And another tool that we sometimes find, so the shark tooth is real, but here's a replica of a shark tooth knife.
The shark tooth knife is like a table knife.
So those were replicas, but this is a real artifact, so you guys have to be very careful because this is very old. This is a spoon that's made out of a seashell.
The seashell spoon is like a soup spoon.
Are you guys ready to practice being archaeologists and look through some real modern garbage?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Okay.
Great. Well, now that we saw the midden, are you guys excited to practice being real archaeologists and go through this magic trash box?
Yes.
Great. Well, we're going to use what's inside to tell a story. So we're going to look at what's inside, and then we're going to try and figure out who made this trash. Okay? Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Do you know what that is?
Baby food?
Yeah, baby food. Oh.
Open.
Lipstick.
Oh.
What's that, Jonathan?
Glasses.
Glasses. Ooh. What does that tell you? What is it?
A nickel.
A nickel?
Toilet paper.
A toilet paper roll.
A receipt.
A receipt.
Exactly. What can we tell about the family who lived here from these items that we took out? So the lipstick, the toilet paper holder, the baby food, the sunglasses, the receipt, and the nickel.
They used to have a lot of things.
Yeah, that they had things, exactly. And we know from the baby food and these little sunglasses, there was probably a little girl in the house.
And we mom. Know,
yes, and an adult. So look at all the things we've learned just from these six pieces of people's trash that they threw out. Thank you so much, guys, for being great archaeologists today.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Miss Mallory. I'm another archaeologist with the Florida Public Archaeology Network. Did we have a lot of fun digging through our modern midden? Awesome. So we are going to learn a little bit more about the kinds of artifacts that we find in middens. When you're an archaeologist, do you think you get most excited about finding gold or silver or rubies, something like that?
Yeah.
You do? You think so? What we get most excited about finding is stuff like pottery, because that can teach us the most about the past. We have examples of plain pottery and incised pottery. When pottery is incised, it means that there's a design carved into it. And Tequesta people would decorate it using carved wooden panels or sable palm fibers or even their fingernails. We get really excited when we find different kinds of patterns because that means people were traveling a long way to trade with each other. Do you think people could ride horses or take a car or take a plane all that way? No, people were taking dugout canoes. So that's the kind of thing that we learned from pottery. Are you guys ready to make some pottery of your own?
Yeah.
Yay!